Switching between databases on different servers in SQL Server Management Studio may be a challenge, as SSMS does not offer this functionality out of box. In the standard connection switch dropdown, I can see all databases from the current server, which might be very inefficient in case I'm connected to a shared SQL server with dozens of databases not accessible for me. SSMSBoost solves this problem and you can see only those databases that you have access to. Moreover, it adds the possibility of switching between recent connections and databases on different servers by one-click action. To take advantage of this functionality, you can add your frequently used connections to preferred connections list. The easiest way to do this is to right-click the desired database in Object Explorer and choose Add to Preferred Connections in the context menu. The first warehouse database is now in my preferred connections list. I press Apply and Close and move on to the next databases from another servers, all added in just one click. Now I have three databases in my preferred connections list. Let me demonstrate another key function of the preferred connections feature. This connection that I have just added is test database, and this one is production database. You surely don't want to run any tests or draft scripts on the production database that may modify or delete some valuable data. This can happen, however, if you often switch between development and production environment, as there is no regular SSMS functionality that can protect you from such errors. In SSMSBoost, I can use connection alias by changing server display name to test and production. That will be used in SSMSBoost connection switch dropdown for better visualization of test and production environment. Furthermore, we have added an important database alert function which will warn you with the preset pop-up message every time you connect to the database that you have defined as important. For additional attention, I can also set the status bar connection color to orange or red. For maximum protection, I recommend enabling these options for all your production databases. In the Preferred Connections section of Connection Switch dropdown, I can now see all three connections that I have recently added. With the help of this function, I can instantly switch between databases on different servers in just one click. Now when I connect to my production database, you can see that status bar color has changed and that the alert pop-up appeared in the lower right corner of the screen. You don't have to specify the database for the connection. If you leave it empty, the default database for your server login will be used. SSMSBoost adds one more useful option called Set as Active Connection. Using regular SSMS functionality, you could only open new query window with a database from Object Explorer. And now you can reconnect currently active SQL query window to any database on any server that you have in your Object Explorer. Please note that it will be connected with the credentials that are displayed on the server node in Object Explorer. Now let's move on to Recent Connections functionality. Whenever you switch connections, the Recent Connections list will grow. To avoid the mess in your Recent Connections list, you can limit the number of recent connections. The default number is 5. You can also set the order of items in Quick Connections switch dropdown. When Accessible Only checkbox is checked, all connections that you don't have access to will be hidden. If you indicated only the server, but not the database in your preferred connections, you can still switch between databases with identical names on different servers in just one click, if this function is enabled. During the reconnection, SSMSBoost will search for the same database name on the new server and will automatically set it active. That is all for today. I hope the tips will help you perform faster and better than you did before. Thumbs up if you like this video and don't forget to share your feedback in the comments below to help us improve this functionality. Thank you for watching and we'll see you next time.